स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज विजय सर, योर केमिस्ट्री टीचर. टुडे आई हैव मेड अ वीडियो फॉर यू स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 10th. इन दिस वीडियो आई हैव स्टार्टेड योर सेकंड चैप्टर विच इज एसिड्स, बेसिस एंड सॉल्ट्स. यू नो I have completed your first chapter by providing a series of 15 videos. If any of you have not gone through the videos provided by me for your first chapter, please go through all the videos in proper order, one after another, to get more and more benefit. Today we have started the second chapter, acids, bases and salts. And in the first part, in the first part of our discussion, we introduce these three terms. Acids, bases and salts are three distinct classes. You know compounds, we have discussed compounds. You are known of the term compounds. You have read about the compounds in the previous class 9th. The compounds, all chemical compounds, almost all chemical compounds can be classified into three parts on the basis of their nature and their characteristic. And these classes are acids, bases and salts. Therefore, here I have written for you, acids, bases and salts are three distinct classes to which belong almost all the chemical compounds, depending on their nature and characteristic. We shall start our discussion on the basis of the earlier attempt to classify the substances or chemical compounds as acids, bases, by the chemist under heading classical. Classical means here old. Old concept. Classical concept of acids and bases. The first of all, we should write classical concepts of acids. Classical concepts of acids. The earlier chemist classified the chemical compounds, the chemical substances as acids on the basis of some properties which we should know under this heading, classical concepts of acid. On the basis of which properties the substances are classified as acid by the earlier chemist. The earlier chemist said, simple, all perhaps you know, and you have read in the previous classes also about some points of these classical concept which I am going to discuss with you in this video. The acids are sour in taste. Sour
simply write sodium test. First point.
Second point, one property, the taste. Means the chemist have tasted, as we taste substance like lemon or unripe mango, unripened grapes, right? These we feel their taste sore. The earlier chemist said these fruits contain acids. Acids have sour taste. And
acid turn blue litmus. Blue litmus to red.
Litmus is an indicator which we shall discuss in the next coming video. About indicator we shall discuss in detail. Here I would like to give you the points which were taken by earlier chemists to classify substances as acid. Aqueous solution of acids conduct electricity.
Aqueous solution of acids conduct electricity. Means aqueous solution of acids are good conductor of electricity.
Right? Next point. There is a reaction. When acid react with base, the acid neutralizes base, base neutralizes acid. They counter their property. The neutralizes bases and produce salt and water.
Neutralizes bases and produce salt and water. Produce salt and water.
This reaction is called neutralization reaction. The next, acids react with active metals such as zinc, magnesium to liberate, which we have discussed in the previous chapter, first chapter in chemical reaction. Reactive metals react with acid to liberate hydrogen gas. In the types of reaction we have read some reaction of metal with acids. The active metals such as zinc or magnesium
react with active metals such as zinc or magnesium to liberate hydrogen gas.
To liberate hydrogen gas. And react with a particular class of compound, carbonate and bicarbonate, to produce, to liberate another gas called carbon dioxide.
react with carbonates or bicarbonates to liberate carbon dioxide, yes, etc. These are the classical concept of acids. On the basis of these properties, earlier chemists classify chemical substances as acids. What are the modern attempts of classification? That we shall discuss later. Now, like acids, there are some counter properties on the basis of which earlier chemists classified substances as bases, which we shall discuss under heading classical concept of concepts of bases. Classical concepts of bases. As we have discussed the test of acid. The acids have sour taste. Bases have bitter taste. The first point, they have bitter taste. They have bitter taste. Changes the color of blue litmus to red is the characteristic of acid, and the opposite characteristic is of base. The bases change the color of red litmus to blue. Change the color of red litmus to blue. One similar property is the aqueous solution of acids. Aqueous solutions conduct electricity. Is a similar property as acid. Aqueous solutions conduct electricity. Aqueous solution of acids as well as aqueous solution of bases are good conductor of electricity. So aqueous solution conducts electricity. React with acid to counter acid properties. Means react with acid to neutralize the acid. As acids neutralizes bases and vice versa. Bases neutralizes acid. React with acid to counter acid properties. React with acid to counter acid properties. Counter acid properties. Give a slippery feeling to the skin. Later we said, no, all soaps, all detergents contain bases.
we used to wash our skin, wash our hand, wash our face and body with different kinds of soaps which are made up of base. So, one property of base which was considered in the classification of substances as bases by earlier chemists is that bases give a slippery feeling to the skin.
Give slippery feeling to the skin. Give slippery feeling to the skin.
And bases react with heavy metal salts to give insoluble precipitate.
React with heavy metal salts to form insoluble precipitate.
Only by saying precipitate, it is understood that it is insoluble salt. We have discussed in the previous chapter. The insoluble, we may write or we cannot write here. Only by writing precipitate it is clear. Bases react with heavy metal salts to form insoluble precipitate. Right? These are the classical concepts of acids and bases. In the next video, we shall start our discussion under the heading indicator. We shall start from the term indicator. First of all, in the next video, we shall discuss the term indicator. Right? Okay. Thank you.